Okay, to get going on disassembling this thing. Right off the top is a thrust washer. You want to make sure you don't lose that, because if you do, you're going to have to buy a new one. So that's there. This top clutch plate's underneath a little bit of spring pressure. You can see you can push down on it, but there is a little bit of spring pressure there, so it's going to come up. And get yourself some snap ring pliers and just see how good you do with it. So we got the snap ring off. Right underneath that's a washer. And when I disassemble things, basically I just turn them upside down and set them in a stacked order. So sometimes it helps you out. I know this pretty well by now. Right on the top is the one of the clutch plates. And we have what's called a drive disc. We've got three little springs, and the purpose of those springs is when you disengage the clutch, it forces things apart to let oil flow through it and cool it all and lubricate it all. So three little springs there. And then we've got a series of clutch discs, and I think on my 60 there's six of them. Some tractors have five. I think some of the bigger tractors have up to 15 of these things. So that's where your serial number and your model number will come into play when you order parts. But anyway, you can just take this quickly apart. And on the bottom of that stack is another clutch plate. It's actually the same part as the one that was on the top. And we get down to this area here. This part's called a clutch adjusting cam. And it comes off, and the way you would do your clutch adjustments is there's a set screw right there. If you run that screw all the way in, and it'll go in easily, and there's no lock mechanism on the screw, and it makes sense because normally centrifugal force on this part is going to make that screw want to come out, if anything, and out is where it locks it into position. So to do your adjustment, you run that screw all the way in, and then these parts will turn independently of one another, and you can adjust your clutch. Anyway, for now, we'll just put that over there. We've got three little balls, and if your clutch is worn out a lot when you go to take this assembly off the tractor, for me, those balls fell out on the ground and rolled around in the grass, and eventually I found them. Lucky, I guess. And we've got this collar. This collar moves back and forth to engage and disengage the clutch. Continuing on with the disassembly, we're down to the brake plate right here. Here's the new one that we're going to put in there. You'll notice that all the facing is wore off of this one. On a 60, these three cap screws are secured with some bend over tabs. And so to kind of speed this video along, I bent them down out of the way. And this part's under some spring pressure, so kind of take it off with the same number of turns all the way around. On, I think, the newer tractors, this brake plate is kind of free-floating to a certain degree, but on this 60, it's bolted down tight, and then the bolts are locked in place with these bend over tabs. Okay, to speed the video along a little bit, I've got these three cap screws pretty well loosened up. And that's the old brake plate right there. You can see, comparing the old ones to the new one there. The new one's got facing both sides. All the facings wore off of this one. It's actually ground into the steel. So it's in bad shape. Another part here is what we call, this is the clutch cam and the disc that's on it. You'll see that the disc is loose. And if you just pull this up, what you're going to find is that you've got a series of springs underneath it. And that's fine. You can take it apart this way, no problem at all. But when you put it back together, it's a little bit different. And I'll show you that later in the videos, I hope. You've got a series of 9 springs in here. And 3 of them, and they're equidistant around, have a secondary spring in them. So those 3 springs have secondary springs in them. And the other 6 springs are just normal springs. Sometimes if your clutch is in really bad shape, those springs will just kind of be powder. And the last thing you've got to take apart here is this washer. So that kind of completes the disassembly. And maybe now we'll just take a quick look at the parts conditions.